Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at four different ways that you can use your iPhone to create images while working on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to its supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So continuity is a feature that allows your iPhone or iPad to work together with your Mac. So you could be working on your Mac and you need an image of some sort, and you can get that through your iPhone. Your iPhone has cameras and a touchscreen, and you can use those to create different images in different situations. So for instance, if you need a photo, you can use your iPhone to take that photo and it goes directly into a file on your Mac. It doesn't reside on the iPhone. You could do the same thing with scans. You could scan using the camera on your iPhone, and that scan, the PDF, goes right into a file on your Mac. You can also draw things using the touchscreen on your iPhone and have the resulting file go right into a new file on your Mac or into a signature in Preview. So the easiest way to use Continuity Camera is to use the Task button at the top of any Finder window. Now you want to be in the place where you want to save the file that you're going to create. So get there first, then use the Task button. And you can see here I can navigate to import from, and for you it might say just from iPhone or it might say just from iPad. For me it's going to say both, because you can see here I've got the ability to grab stuff through Continuity Camera from both my iPhone and my iPad that are nearby. And there are three different types of files I can get from my iPhone. One is just to use the camera to take a regular photo. The other is to make a scan using the camera. And the third is to actually do a sketch. So it's not going to use the camera at all, but allow me to draw on the screen of the iPhone using markup tools. Now I'm going to start by trying to take a photo. So you see when I do that, my iPhone shifts to this screen that's basically a view from the camera app. And I get to take a photo here. And once I take the photo, I tap the Use Photo button, and that sends it to my Mac. The iPhone returns to what it was doing, and I have the image now in the Finder at that location on my Mac. So this is really useful if you have a job or a hobby where you have to take pictures of objects all the time to use them in documents or just put them as part of a project on your Mac. And you don't want to have that cluttering up your photo library and have the whole multi-step process of taking the picture on your iPhone and then getting it out of the photo library, deleting it from the photo library, and everything like that. You could just take the picture and have it go right to a file here in the Finder. You could even skip the Finder and not have it be a file at all. Here I am in Pages, and I can click the Media button, and you see I have the ability to import from my iPhone or iPad in the same way here, except it goes directly into this Pages document. It never even exists as an independent file. So in addition to taking photos, you can also use the cameras on your iPhone or iPad to scan a document. It could be a one-page document or a multi-page document. Taking a scan is much like taking a photo. The difference is that the scanning view is going to try to find a piece of paper or something that's a rectangular sheet of some sort, and it's going to take a picture of that but then correct its perspective so it's always flat even if you're taking the picture at an angle. And you can also add multiple sheets of paper to the scan before you finally hit save, and then it sends it to the Mac and the iPhone returns to what it was doing. So in addition to cameras, the other thing your iPhone or iPad has going for it is of course a touchscreen. And you can use a touchscreen to draw on, which is really useful if you want to create a sketch. Something you can't easily do on your Mac. I mean, you can draw using your trackpad or mouse, but sometimes it's much easier to draw with a touchscreen. So using this to create a sketch works in much the same way, except it's not using the camera at all. You basically get a blank canvas and you get the markup tools that you can use to draw in other places in iOS. So you get like a pencil, pen, highlighter, you can use a ruler, you can do all sorts of different things right there on your screen by touching and drawing on it. And when you're done, it saves that image to your Mac, and your iPhone once again returns to what it was doing before. Now where this really shines is if you're using an iPad and you've got an Apple Pencil. Then you can use that to draw a sketch and have it go directly into a file on your Mac. Not only can these sketches go into files in the Finder, but they can go directly into documents like Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, the same way we did photos. You may have noticed that you could take a scan and do a sketch and have them go directly into documents that you're working on. In addition, you can also use this to create a signature. You do this in the Preview app. Now the Preview app for a while has had the ability for you to make a signature using your Mac's camera. You sign a sheet of paper and you hold it up to the camera, or you can use your trackpad and sign the trackpad. But now a third option appears, and that's to use your iPhone's touchscreen to create a signature. But to create a signature this way, you have to be in preview, of course, and then you go to add a signature. So you go into the markup tools, you go to add a signature, and you may see the ones you've already created there. But you have the ability to create a new signature, and now your iPhone appears as an option. And then your iPhone changes to the screen where you could sign the screen, and then that will get added to your list of signatures in preview. And then you could add it to the document you're working on, and the signature remains around so you could add it to future documents as well. Now for this to work, your devices should be using the latest operating systems. In addition, they've got to have Bluetooth turned on, Wi-Fi turned on, even though they're talking directly to each other, still using Wi-Fi to accomplish that. And they both need to be using the same Apple ID, of course, and two-factor authentication to make it all secure. Apple has more information here at this page of what you need to use these continuity features and lists even more places where they can be used as well. So it's great to see Apple adding more continuity features. I hope they continue to do that. One thing I would love to see is continuity video. I would love to be able to use my iPhone as a video camera and have the video go directly into my Mac as a stream. In other words, use my iPhone as a webcam. That would be awesome. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.